Hi, I'm Michele Mauri, Scientific Director of Density Design Lab, focused on information design and data visualization. In this lesson, we want to make an introduction to data visualization. Data visualization involves the creation and the study of visual representation of data. Today, many software and tools are available to create data visualization, and the risk is that, given a dataset, we don't know how to visualize it in the best way. Given an array of possible visualization, the risk is to focus on the available possibilities. In this lesson, we want to make a step behind understanding why we visualize data. I will use it as an umbrella term to any kind of artifact, from static and printed ones to animated visualization to interactive ones. The visualization of data is not something new. It's from centuries ago the first known visualization on a coordinate system representing planetary movements. But what is the reason why it was not just described in words but visualized? The answer is pretty simple. We use visualization to take advantage from our natural abilities. It's estimated that 70% of all sensory receptors are located in our eyes. Our brain is trained to interpret visual information often without being aware of it. We can call it preattentive processes. Like in this case, it's difficult not to focus on the red dots. In fact, in our everyday life, we are used to visually compare the objects around us, identifying pale and bright colors, evaluating the size and the distance of the different objects. The visualization uses these automatisms to visually communicate data. It could be better on different levels: more immediate, more clear, more interesting, more detailed, or more interweaved. This list is to recall that visualizations can have a different goal than being quick or compelling. In order to use these automatisms in a way that it's useful for our goals, a common approach is the one originally developed by Jacques Bertin, in which we have markers on a two-dimensional space. Marks are visual items used to represent data. They can be points, lines, or areas. Each marker can have different visual features: the position, the shape, the color, and many others, as systematized more recently by Roth. In this table, you can see the result of the study in which visual variables were tested among a group of people. Variables are ranked from the most efficient to the least one, according to the number of tasks they allow. The visual feature, therefore, can allow the reader to perform different operations: associate, isolate items, read categories, read orders from the first to the last item, or read quantities. It's clear that the position in space is the most relevant variable. You can use it for associations, reading groups, or selections, highlighting single items, but also to show order, like in the case of a list, or quantities, for example, in a scatter plot. Let's take some other visual features. Here, for example, we are looking to four ways of encoding information on a grid of markers. Look at the top left one. The color hue is very powerful in communicating as groups of markers, but it fails in communicating a reading order or quantities. Also, shapes are good in communicating groups, even if in a less powerful way, and again, no order nor quantities are communicated. On the other side, using color hue, bottom right, it is possible to read an order from the darkest to the palest color, but no groups, and it's difficult to read quantities. The last example is using size. This variable is very powerful in communicating quantities, since we can quickly identify smaller and bigger items, but it's not suitable for groups or order. So, two reflections are relevant. First, not all the visual variables are equal. Some of them are stronger. This means that in the moment we decide to encode data with a particular variable, we are defining also the relevance of such data. Secondly, you can encode as much as that as you want, but this won't mean that your reader will be able to decode it. To conclude, it's worth remembering that Bertin also stated that the visual variable's properties are valid under specific conditions. Representable or printable, on a sheet of white paper, of a standard size visible at a glance, at a distance of vision corresponding to the reading of a book or an atlas, under normal and constant lighting. It could seem trivial, but it's not. At this moment, you are looking at visualization, not on paper. You don't need an ambient light since your monitor emits light, and the distance of reading is different. In fact, the device on which you will design the visualization brings its own features in the project. We will see this concept in the next lesson.